Hi, Con here.
I'm going to ring about my flight. Oh, Morris. In the flight place. Keith. Hello, Mina. He left. Flight for his car. Yes, can I speak to Hedwini, please? Keith, sorry.
Yeah, just a moment.
Thanks.
Good morning, Keith here.
Keith, John Wano here.
G'day, how are you?
Good, thanks. I'm just checking up with our flags. Are they on the way or what?
They're being sent.
Oh, yeah. I haven't got them yet.
Okay,
thanks.
Thank you.
All right. I better check in the office. Might be down there already. So on the subject of where we are, at the moment, while he's tracking the flags from Flags New Zealand and Roma Road, Mount Roskill, he's a good guy, Keith. I got 20 flags from way back, in the days of Mohi Manukau, for the Confederation of Chiefs, and this flag. And flag's going to Malta, to Prince Peter, and Edu Manukau was there at the time. So I've never heard back anything since then. So I'm going to follow that up before long to hook all that back together, since Rapa Nui has got its country back to my people, the Wanoa people from Raiatea Island and Rapa Nui to Moko Nui at the East Coast, on North Island, New Zealand, and Tikitiki, Rangitukia, and Haha landblocks, Marangaro landblocks, where Te Pito is marked on Google Maps. You'll see it there. You have a good look at the world map, Earth World, and see that it's marked there to Te Pito at Anakena in East Island. So that's my mawai in London. That more than likely will be going back home. That's the stolen moai. Queen Victoria stole them in 1868 and took them in the ship Topaz, the HM ship Topaz, to England and hid them away for 100 years. So that's our memorial that's broken our families up. The British white people have done all these things to everybody else in the world, and in particular my family, to break us up here in New Zealand at the same time. So they're sorting themselves out. However they're going to do, that's I'm talking about Ngāpuhi tribes that I've been involved with for years, have got their own ideas of how they're going to address this issue. But really, they can't do anything with this flag because it's a contract and they have got no papers to do it and have lost confidence in me. But that's not lost forevermore because they've got a problem with the iwi Maoris who have been sucking the living daylights out of this flag and giving the mana to the Queen, Victoria and Queen Elizabeth, and the Rothschild banks and Trump and everybody else that who doesn't have a contract with this flag and the king. Maori do not have a contract with this flag. There were no Maoris in 1820 when Te Re Waikato Wharehere Manukau went to England and signed a contract to make a deal with King George IV And this flag was the result of a contract that was already set up in 1823 or thereabouts in Edinburgh Magistrate Court. And Lieutenant William Symonds, Cornwallis Symonds, that's where the name Cornwallis Symonds comes from, written to here. And Ngā Puihi and Ngāti Whātua o Raki and Ngāti Whātua o Kaipara have tampered with this flag and its contract by bringing in a confederation of chiefs and corrupted the whakapapa of Te Rā Waikato Wharehere Manukau from Maunga Tautari Mountain and his tribal people there. I've got the name of that tribe as being the Maunga Tautari Marae, Kahu Punga Punga. That is the hapu, chiefs of Maunga Tautari and the Manukau, Te Rā Waikato Wharehere Manukau. Now, it looks like this. People were invading each other because the British set them up to invade each other, and then the British stepped in and invaded them. In the end, the tribes were invading each other. In the process, the people from Maniapoto and Te Rauparaha on the west coast came in and invaded these kahu, punga, punga, moriori, manukau chiefs off their land, and that's who's there now. Tainui, King Koriki, and King Tuhaitia have taken that title from Maunga Tautari Mountain, and they cannot prove that they were here first when they slipped their waka, Tainui, into the Manukau Harbour. I had a court hearing with the Office of Treaty Settlements for the Y121 Manukau claim with Mohi Manukau. And I said to the Office of Treaty Settlements, Rachel Holbrook, take that name Manukau off all the other treaty claims and what have you got? And she tried to tell me that I have to abide by the 1840 Treaty of Waitangi principles of the treaty. I said, no, we don't. Here's the birth certificate for Manukau's, Otai Manukau and the rest of the Manukau's, and it's 1830. There's 1830, 1831, 1834 here. Now, that's British birth certificates. You can't take that away from Mohi. And so she gave up with me and left it at that and says, well, you're the exception. And everybody else has to go to 1840, cut off. So all your treaty claims, iwi, Maori, you are cut off at 1840. You cannot go into this 1834 flag at all because the government made a deal with all your tribes, Ngāti Kau, Ngāti Kuri, Te Rōrua, Ngāti Kawa, Ngāti Wai, and Ngāti, the tribes up up north. All the Ngāti Kuris, they all signed the treaty. You're stuck outside of this flag. You cannot use this flag. I'm telling you, I'm the law here with these documents and this flag intact as a British contract, not your contract. You got a contract with the Queen, which is not there. She's not there. The Queen Victoria titles and King Edwards. Or Kingi Taurua Edwards, you got to go with his Queen Victoria and King Edward line. That's that side of a contract. You've got that contract in New South Wales. Government in Australia, New Zealand company that stole the Manukau company's title, and that's what I'm going with the Manukau title, Manukau company title to Edinburgh in Glasgow. In Maunga Tautari, Cambridge to Cambridge, England. Cambridge to Cambridge, England. Cambridge, Te Rā Waikato Wharehere Manukau's land that Tainui has stolen off Maunga Tautari Mountain and these kahu, punga punga, paramount chiefs. who were few, but then Georgie Job and Alfred Mitchell's thugs came across from Taranaki and raided the Manukau's land. The real Manukau, male dominant bloodline, surname, chiefs, land, and Mangatauturi, and put their titles on. Well, I'm going to strip those titles off there under this British title, because the British knew who was who, and they got the guns. Sorry to tell you, they have the guns. So the Kahu Punga Punga story lived at Wai Mahana on the Waikato. Hot Springs there, his canoe was called Tiki Tere. That's where Moira Hoffman lives. Moira Hoffman Russell lives. And her whakapapa that I've got here that trounces all of your whakapapa to Rairi, Kupe, and Puhi. It makes all your whakapapas wrong. And Te Ripo, chief, and Mahanga chief married a woman called Tira Waikato. They made it up. And your Ngāti Kauas come off that, Tororoa comes off that, Ngāti Kahu comes off that up north. All you tribes up north, and Te Uriahau, and Te Tau, and Ngāti Whātua Ōraki, Ngāti Whātua O Kaipara, comes off that bodgy Tera Waikato line. I've caught you out, and I'm going to stick this 960 million trillion pound note right over your heads on the left side, the Queen's contract side, from the King and the Flag's contract. It's a contract, it's the New World Order. I'm telling you, it's the Freemasons documents you're playing around with. They got contracts on people's heads that get in a row, a two-party contract between me, Morris Baker, Moira Hoffman, and the First Lord of the Sea, Sir Philip Jones, Royal British Navy. That's our partner. There, just that lot. The others have gone the other way. Money went to his Ratna Church, who duped Rewharewha Manukau's title and took that name, Rewharewha Manukau, and locked them up in Apihai Te Kawau, little prison on Kawau Island, named the island he stole off Te Arawa, all those islands out there, Rangitoto, all those are Te Arawa names, Ihinga, the son of Tamatakapua's other son, Tūra Matakaka. Ngāti Mamoe was the tainer in Rotorua, and Tūra Matakaka up north was the tuakana. Yeah, I know all the whole lot. I know everything. And you, Alfred Mitchell, and your Mitchell family are the thugs, pirates from Australia, New South Wales, who duped all these Manukau titles. You fellas were all in it, no matter who did what. You're all caught up in that confederation of tribes carving that Mohi Manukau had, and no one was listening to him, and no one was listening to each other. They were only listening to themselves, like you, Alfred. You have no titles to anything. Only on the west coast, Maniapoto and Tainui, you folks got booted out of the negotiations with the Crown Corporation. They booted you sideways. They didn't take you seriously, Alfred, and they still don't now. Maniapoto and Georgie Job, you fellas are alien to Australia. Queen Victoria and King Edward, not this flag. You can take the flag off your neck, Alfred, because it doesn't ring a bell with any legal authority to you. It's a contract. I've got the contract papers right here. Straight to Britain with Moira Hoffman, and the Russells who put these titles together with the Rogans and the Cosgroves, my family, and the Patrick, St. Patrick, my family in Northern Ireland, Belfast. I can speak for them and speak for the King, William III, the Dutchman, and King George III, the father of King William IV, King George IV, and King Ernest Augustus I. Those are who I'm talking to. Those who I'm talking about, kings. Now, you fellas don't talk about kings. You only talk about flags. You haven't got the full quid over it. You fellas can't say anything because you fellas have been fashioned by the Pākehā thugs from Australia and New Zealand BI government. They got nothing to stand up against the documents I have for this flag. I'm going to get them authenticated because when they become authenticated in Britain and here, that's the law of these lands. Offer it. It's got my name on it. Manukau's name on it. Mora's name on it. And Lobo, Morris Baker's name on it, on a British title. So you better make your own titles. Then get your own government, Maori government. That's the Maori government operating in Wellington, the Beehive. There's already a Maori government there, Alfred, you stupid bugger. And Georgie Dobb will join that one. Because they're using everything you're using, the Ture Whenua Act, they're using the New Zealand Australia Acts of their own government, they're using a Dud Queen, that you fellas can only go under the Dud Queen. You can't use this flag because you've got nothing to back yourselves up. You only got myths of stories you can't stick your name to. Alfred, you can't stick your name to anything other than selling lands that wasn't yours in the first place. And Georgie Dobb, you're from down Maniapoto with Sue Nakura. She fashioned the Maori Land Court Acts for the Labour government as a Maori policy maker for a Maori government that's in Wellington. She worked for the Labour government, Maori government. Using Te Ture Whenua Acts, 93, that was when that was invented, and the 1945 Maori Land Court Act, and stole the 1862 Rewharewha Manukau Rogan Native New Zealand Act, 1862 Native New Zealand Act, come out of this flag and Te Re Waikato Whare Here Here Manukau from his Maunga Tautari Marae and his Ngā, his Kahu Punga Punga tribe. Right? His Moriori Kahu Punga Punga tribe. There, that you fellas stop. You, Georgie Dobb. And Alfred, I'm holding you fellas to account on this video while I'm waiting for Keith Hiriwini and the flags. He's tracking down the flags for Morris Lobo Baker for his car, the flags. They've got 200 miles an hour winds. It'll stand 200 miles an hour wind with a strong flags. Well, you'll have to go pretty fast before they rip apart. And for weather as well. So, Tiki Tere, where Moira lives, in Tiki Tere, in Rotorua, in the Hot Springs, that was Te Re Waikato Whare Here Here Manukau's land. See? That was his land, Okarari. That was all his land, Okarari and Maunga Tautiri, Cambridge. All that area around there, Rotorua, the whole area was his. Still is. If you can prove it's not, then timely you've got a problem. Where the hell do you come from? Johnny come lately. I must say that way my friend Dion Baiko Walker, or Waka, or that's his name, but he's with Tainui religiously. The king's side, King Tuheitia, and the hill where the burial grounds are. Taupiri. Taupiri Mountain. When you take those names, Maunga Tautiri, Taupiri, and find who they came from, they've come out of this Maunga Tautiri Marae, that they've flogged and put their people, because the Crown, you shouldn't put them in there. The British Crown will remove them, because the British know who's who from the whakapapa that Morris got. It just wiped you fellas right off. Alfred and Georgie Job, it writes you fellas right off, because the British were going all over the place invading you fellas, invading these other ones. Right? So that marae, you fellas changed it. King Koriki and Queen Dame Te Aotearangi Kahu changed it, but see, she's got the name Kahu. Where that's come from, it's a strange one. And that's the part that the woman have no line to whakapapa. It's male line dominant in a Moai world and a king's world. It's male line. Under Salic law, forbids women to succeed to the throne in England, and that's the way I see it. The female sold the lands, the male holds the land for his common people. There's the trouble started with the Queen, Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth and the Rothschilds. That's where it's gone haywire. We're going to reverse that with this power note and this flag and strip them all and put it back where the King had it intact. All right? I'm still waiting for... Keith, checking my flags. Taking a long time. But anyway, while he's there, I'm just on magistrate courts at the moment with a court case with the World Court. The World Court has no jurisdiction over the magistrate court in cases that are beyond £1 trillion. Right? They can't handle it. They have no jurisdiction to handle a case on admiralty that goes beyond £1 trillion or even beyond £1 million. They have no jurisdiction in the World Court to talk for Britain. Britain will talk for itself. The EU Parliament cannot talk for Britain. Only Britain can talk for Britain. That's where those people in Westminster who are supporting EU Parliament, I'm coming there with this flag to boot the whole lot of you out with the King's authority and jurisdiction of a magistrate's courts over you. You're working for the EU Parliament, you can go back over there. We'll boot you out. We're going to boot and strip you. Strip everything off you because you're tampered with our contract with this flag. We still have a valid, legal, legitimate King's contract with the First Lord of the Sea, Sir Philip Jones, Royal British Navy, and us, me, Maurice Baker, and Maura Hoffman Ruttle, at the present time. Those are the only three going to England. I'm making this announcement because Manahi has upset me, Kingi Taurua has upset me, and Bundy has not upset me, and Heriwini Karaka has not upset me, but certainly the Ratna Church has really upset me in abandoning Lobo and Maurice Baker and his little church, House on the Prairie, on Taheke Horeke Road in Hokianga. They've abandoned it. Now they want to sell the church. The Methodist church in Mangungu belongs to Hori Tikuri. He was a minister in that church from his appointment from Whirinaki, where the Russells and the Busbys lived, on the other side of Oponani, and that's where Maura's family, Russells, first came into Hokianga in the 1820s, notably 1823 to 1827 period of British authority being stamped in 1823 at least on our documents, that allowed them the legal right to be there at that period of time with Te Reo Waikato, Whare Here Here Manukau, in Cambridge, England, and in Edinburgh Magistrate Court, signing documents to sell this country, New Zealand, to King George IV, right then and there, 1820 to 1830 period of time, when the slave took over the contract, that contract into 1830, King William IV and Rewharewha Manukau to 1834, 20th of March 1834, this flag was for Rewharewha Manukau from Te Reo Waikato Manukau, Te Reo Waikato Whareherere Manukau and King George. The extension of a legal private contract of Admiralty Magistrate Court continued on into this flag. That's why no one can talk for it. And it's not for anybody to use this flag without our authority. Now, those Maoris who use this flag outside of the Waitangi Marae and Waitangi National Trust and Peter Parodi, I'm holding him to usurping this flag for Maori in the Queen's Bench Court. This is not his contract in Queen Elizabeth or Queen Victoria contract. They cannot use this flag against us, the legal title holders of this contract, private contract. This flag, that's why the New Zealand government doesn't fly this flag. It tried to sneak it with the ship, Spirit of Adventure ship, flying it on it with Charlie Hoepa and a few others that were duping around with it. Charlie Hoepa has no right to this flag. His name Hoepa is Joseph. He has no right to this flag in the wrong jurisdiction, buying land back, and then duped his own people into mortgages. It was just the opposite to this flag. You see? He violated this flag, tampered with it. Anybody that's tampered with it and got caught is wearing the bill, the 970 million trillion pound note bill. And because you, Manahi, got involved with my friend Robo and his land titles and his little church, it's nobody's business. But you offended me because it upset me with tampering with Lobo, and you use them to go and sign your documents. That's all he wanted to do, to sign your documents for your church. We're not too bothered about churches. He's not even a church man, although he's in a church every day. He's got his own trakias to his own self, his own way, in that church house that I was in. I feel it. I've slept in that church money. I can feel all its mana inside it that's been ruined by Haywood Brown and his cohorts down in Rātama, Whanganui. The Maniapoto people have ruined everything in that church that was set up. I'm going to put it right. I'm going to put it right because that's our business. And Mohi Manukau was just as bad as you guys. You were all in the same because he was running the Ngāti Whātua o Rākei, part of the deal, the ISIS of New Zealand, and against you guys because that was a mixture of Ngāpuhi, Arawa, Tainui, and Aotea tribes inside that four pillar confederation of chiefs. And then Ngāpuhi made their own confederation, and that backfired. You know why? Because you fellas are flying this flag and no one knew anything about banks, mortgages, liens, property, money, gold, shipping, manifest, bill of lading, legal documents, lawyers, judges, police, protection, military, army, navy, air force. None of any one of you knew everything of that, all wrapped up in one, including tikanga, law of the land. Vandals of England. None of you have got that. I'm carrying all that lot with me. And a good measure of all the whakapapa and titles. Exactly what Moira gave me, her titles and her whakapapa, the same as what Mohi Manukau and all the other Confederation members gave me, all their whakapapa and titles. It's behind this couch, Alfred Mitchell. It's all behind this couch. I don't know what you fellas going on about writing about me. That's offensive. You've offended this flag and me, and Lobo, and Moira. We have more British right to this British flag than you Australian thugs. I'm saying on this video. Okay, so that's while I'm here, I just want to straighten things out about this flag. And where's that other flag? I'll just get that somewhere. I'll put it somewhere. I just want to mention one more bit about it. The flag. I've got some film left. The flag. I'm going to explain the flag to you, Daryl Payne and Rennie Powers in California, and Joseph Kinematau Harvey, Joseph Kinematau, chief of the tribes in Canada, and his friend Raymond Faithful. I'll explain this flag. You have 4 8-point stars of St. Patrick, Church Order in Belfast, Northern Ireland. St. Patrick is buried there. As a born Catholic in Rome, but then he went to England and he became a bishop. Under his father was collecting all the king's royal revenue as a minister. A very wealthy man. But St. Patrick was not interested in any wealth or fortunes of his father. So he went to Northern Ireland where the poor people are and helped them. And he established the St. Patrick's Church, his own church. He didn't want the Church of England because it was corrupted. He didn't like it. So I'm talking about the 8-point star. And so he set up his church and then got banned. He got debarred as a bishop of England. His dad chucked him out, and so did Westminster. So he carried on building his churches right through Northern Ireland and the rest of Ireland, and became famous for bringing people together, the poor people. So that's where that came from. The municipalities and the principalities of commerce of King William III, he put that together, 8-point star, as his title, to collect all the rent, ground rent, rates, fines, administrative costs to run a conquered country. And so the British in the St. Patrick, they put this flag together over there and they gave it to the chiefs here, paramount chiefs, to choose three flags. They chose this one with these four white stars of St. Patrick. Without too much knowledge about what it meant. They just liked it. Okay? They weren't too worried about churches or anything else. They just wanted a flag and nothing else. Just to connect, to keep the thugs off this land. That's what it was for. A protectorate from the 8-point star of King William III. He created the banknote, the pound note, which King Tafio from Waikato was given the license for to print the pound note or to sell the pound note, but he bought the pound note from England under this King William III, 1694, Bank of England Act, and the Pound Note and Coins Act, Gold Coins Act. We use those acts of King William III and the pound note to bill debt anybody with that 8-point star that I'm wearing on my hat and over here on the badge on the shirt. Okay, and John Key's wearing it, he's going to wear that bill on his head. Everyone that's tampering with this flag and our contract with the kings, I said, King William III, King George III, King George IV, King George IV, King William IV, and King Ernest Augustus I, and our reigning monarch at the present time is King And if it does, it's the fifth King of Hanover, Britain, of the New Zealand Pacific Islands, and our oath of office is to him and this flag and us, his partner, in Westminster Government, okay? And Westminster Magistrate Court, and me, the magistrate, here to go there to put the flag up and carry on with him as our King of Britain, UK, okay? Got that? And so now we've got that established in, he was buried in Northern Ireland in Belfast. And that's my title there with the Rogan Land Agents here and Australia, Rogans, surveyors, land surveyors and magistrates, and Cosgrove lawyers at the time. That's our title with coat of arms of those kings, and the St. Patrick's Church Order and St. Mary's Church Order in Edinburgh, the Holy Grail, to Tiki Tiki on the land box in my Rahui Marae Native Court, and the Native Court in Rangitukia, our Native Magistrate Office there, Native Magistrate Office there, and also the St. Patrick's Church Order in Belfast. That's my titles that I'm holding with this flag of jurisdiction. Now we go from the four corners of the earth in the blue sea of Admiralty. That's the private part of business that belongs to us. And the four corners of the earth, with these kings I just said, under that jurisdiction of Admiralty, and the sky, blue sky, through the sky, under the sea, and in the sea, on top of the sea, and on the land. This black strip around this red, little red cross, is the seal to keep out the devil, Satan, and it is military, the British military, and other militaries around the world we are partners with, this 8-point star in the four corners of the earth, all their militaries as well, inside to protect this cross, the small cross, with those five kings that I just mentioned, and the big cross is the six King Georges, right? The big cross is King Georges, and also the Vatican is stuck in that as well with the Queen, okay? All the monarchs come out of that red cross. And so that's the flag. The white is just the background. That's for neutral, common law. The white flag is peace, goodwill, harmony, and love. And so that's the story of the flag, which is life. It was given to us on the 20th of March, 1834, for Referefa Manukau and his Moriori Manukau title to this Kahu, Punga Punga, Hapu, Paramount Chiefs of Mangatauturi Marae in Cambridge, to Cambridge, England, to Cambridge here. Okay, so that's the connection with this flag and that chief to his ancestor that was in Edinburgh signing documents that went to England, to Cambridge, to learn English from his Cambridge, to that Cambridge. That's the Waikato chief. Everybody else that's playing around with the Waikato name is fraudulent on this side of the Queen that have tampered with that tupuna's name and his tribe. The thieves are Ngāti Raukawa, thieves of the Kahu Pungapunga land of Mangatauturi. The father is Manaia. Okay, Manaia has got the whete, came to the island of Aotearoa. So the country. See? That's the country. The Moriori. He saw no men. See, this guy, Manaia, and his pit whete came to the island of Aotearoa and saw no men here. Kahu Pungapunga story lived at Waimahana on the Waikato Hot Springs. There his canoe was called Tikitere. That's where Moira Hoffman lives, in Rotorua, on the way to Hell's Gate, opposite to Hell's Gate, Hongi's Hell's Gate, Hongi Hika, right? You can see the resemblance of Hongi going to England with Te Rā Waikato together, but Hongi wasn't no cousin of his. Hongi was a Cook Island Tahitian. Te Rā Waikato Whareherehere was a separate Moriori chief from Rihu Country Island, which is called Chatham Islands now. Okay, so there was a UFO country of Manukau's came from there to here. The Manukau name came from there to here. The Hikurangi name came from here to here. The Waitangi name came from there to here. All those names over there came from there to here, not from here to there. They took these Maoris here, took the name Wharekori from here to there, and stuck it on the land and made it Wharekori, and took off the old name of Manukau. Manukau's name is there. So, no question about that. The British know who's bullshitting who. So that's the confederation of chiefs, whakapapa, to four main tribes, Aotea, Waikato, Ngāpuhi, and Te Arawa. Okay, those are the four main tribes, and then you've got Waitaha, the early Maoris before 1820 who jumped on a man without any authority, that's Danny Watson and his group. Okay, and then you've got Pākehā, other Pākehā that came later. So you've got at least the four main tribes, and everybody else came after that. Dating from 300 AD, Maui, East Island, they've got their island back now from Chile, 126 years or 187 years of Chile dominance. Is Chile's given it back, because I think now the British have told them to give it back. Now the British will say, give this country back. And I've got all the economic plans for here. The tidal turbine's ready to go in Scotland here on the east coast of my land blocks. And for the very first time in all these 68 years of my life, I've never been able to get on one of the 31 land blocks that got my name on it as an original native land owner, commercial landowner with my name in capitals. And there's my name in capitals, people. When you see your name in capitals like this, the Crown Corporations of New South Wales and New Zealand are making $100 million out of it, and I get only $26,000 out of it for my gold card pension. That's all I get. I'm running this whole business on $26,000 a year and pays for my medication before, not now, because I need that money to keep me going. See, so I save all that money. The thug, drug addicts, drug dealers in the pharmacies are making money with their doctors as criminal. Okay, criminal against this flag jurisdiction. And so now I've put £1 trillion on this, £1 trillion on my name, as everyone in the world, there's at least 5 billion people in the world, minus the elite people, at £1 trillion each. That's why I'm putting 970 million trillion pounds on everybody that's on this side, against the king, and this side, and this side. So I hope that answers your question, Darryl Payne, and a few other people who want to know about this fact. This fact goes to the four corners of the earth, free passage. It has a free passage with British military protection. And what I'm doing with the pound note, I'm cutting it down and writing out $20 billion to pay the British military, navy, to go for the missing gold and the missing money. There's 300 million metric tons of gold in the Caribbean that belongs to our trust. And the 1.5 million metric tons of gold in the Philippines. I'm going there to see my girlfriend and see President Rodriguez Duterte and tell him, let's cut a deal and get his share of it, because he can't even touch that. It's under a contract with us, right here, with these Maoris duping this whakapapa. It's fraudulent. This whakapapa that me and Moi Manukau put it together painfully in 6 year period. We put this together. And the carving here, that's there as well, with this parliament and everything on it, was fashioned with this as a confederation to take this country over. Now I've got a plan, electronic plan, to take this country and put it straight into the economic development project of hydrogen economy. Okay, I've got that all ready to go with Scotland and Ireland and England as the old British, now the new Brits. Well, I'm going there to save Brexit and to boot out all those politicians inside of the Parliament in Westminster. Boot them all out. Anybody talk about EU, out they go. The Lord's anybody. This flag's going to boot you all out. It's the contract to put this flag up over there and wipe the lot of you out and wipe Trump out and all those thugs in America out and the ones in Canada and that president, chuck them out. Australia, chuck them out. Turnbull, chuck them out. Chuck out. Jacinda, chuck out the whole lot here. They get the £1 trillion on their head, on their birth certificate. We're pulling the shots now. The debtor, that lot. We've got the debtor, this is the judgment debtor, and this is the judgment creditor. Okay? The judgment creditor, right here. Your name's in the capital, you're a judgment creditor. In this flag, and its jurisdiction. So, the last bit of this flag is this. It doesn't have to change going into any country. It's the same flag that goes, you can't change it, put it on another one. It represents the whole world. The Commonwealth countries of the world, is this flag that can go into any country. 250 countries we've got online on the website starting up next week, hopefully this week or next week. Cecile Hoods is managing the new website. The old MoaiPowerhouse.com website will be just information only and referral going across to the new website specifically for shares in the Moai tidal turbines and this flag that takes the turbine bridges and construction right around the world. And we use this flag in other countries for you, the members, to come as a British citizen under this flag of jurisdiction that started off all the wealth in the world was these kings I just told you. The four kings in the five kings in this cross in the middle. I'll say them once again. King William III, King George III, King George IV, King William IV, King Ernest Augustus I, and now King Ernest Augustus V, reigning monarch of Britain, UK, Hanover, and Aotearoa, New Zealand, Pacific Islands, and the Commonwealth countries, 250 countries in the world, and this flag going around the world. And you, Daryl, and Renee, this flag will wipe any titles off the land because it put those titles on the land in the first place through the magistrate courts into their district courts and supreme courts and everything is subject to this king who made those laws in the first place. The king created all the laws of Westminster that got you onto the land in the first place. Okay? That's come from this flag and it's chiefs, natives on native lands, all the native lands in the world comes under this flag, and the native lands in America comes under this flag of jurisdiction over the courts that are there usurping the king's authority to be making their laws on top of laws on top of laws and statutes wiped out with this and Westminster. Gonna wipe that all out once we take Cook Street title, that House of Cards will fall over like a domino and the rest is history. That's why we're billing them first and then boot them. Right? We're billing everybody first. All the bills are out now and I'm just authenticating them and that's the end of all the Queen's business and the Rothschild banks will be bankrupted. That flag is a bankrupt flag. It's a pirate flag for pirates who get in the way of a two-party contract. The third party, the Rothschild banks, the Queen, all her business, the corporations in the world, the United States of America, US federal state government, United Nations, NATO, EU Parliament, City of London, Vatican City, Washington DC, NZ Tuition, New Zealand, NZ Invest Limited, New Zealand, Waitangi National Trust, Wellington, Parliament, New Zealand Parliament, Cabinet, and all the private companies in the world who are using the Crown system of New Zealand and Australia and Britain without this King's title, right? No one's using this title, no one has the authority to use this title, only the Paramount Chiefs. In this jurisdiction, not the Queen's jurisdiction. Peter Peroni, if you've been using this flag and your government and your iwi Maoris, you're in trouble. You've got £1 trillion on your head right now. Okay? When I first notified you that all the treaty claims come under this, at less than 1%, you thugs, less than 1%, that's all that's worth. On the treaty claims and the whakapapa here, this is more accurate than anything. But it's stolen all its whakapapa and history off the Manukaus. That's the offence. They stole it off Warren Hoffman, Russell, and stolen it off the Mangatauteri Hapu of the Manukau Moriori tribe called Kahu Punga Punga at Mangatauteri Marae. They've stolen their history. Split Te Rewaikato's name in half and put the Te Rewaikato as a female in all their whakapapa of Ngāti Whātua o Raki, Ngāti Whātua o Kaipara, and all those tribes up there. All their whakapapa comes out of this Te Rewaikato woman and this Ripiro man and this Mahanga man. Two men screwing this make-believe Te Rewaikato woman. That's not there. It's not there. They made that up. Impute that. Okay? And now they're going to get this on their head. My shirt came back in this packet from the New Zealand CIB Police. Criminal Investigation Bureau. The crooks themselves gave up. Lost the case against me as insufficient evidence. Everything they threw at me. Now this is my evidence. This is my evidence against them. £1 trillion on each one's head and stripped every one of them. All the police. Or make them come and work for this trade under a new contract. That's what I'm going to put on them. A new contract. And the British military, a new contract. I'm going to write the pound note against all the thugs on this side. You see, I'm going to pick out the thugs out of the police. All the other ones, there's good ones and there's bad ones. The ones at the top, whack, at the head. But this is an execution act flag for pirates who get in a row of a two-party contract. Whip their heads off under contract, right? That's what the Freemasons do. They've got contracts on their heads of people who get in the road and phew, the next minute they'll disappear for playing around with this contract and this flag. Right? This lot is going to get the bill. When I finish putting all these documents together, I'm making sure you know clearly what I'm talking about as a king's surrogate to talk for the kings. No one's talking for the kings anywhere in the world except me. That's it. As a Maui crown legal authority. Truth prevails over bullshit, thuggery, and lies. Okay, so that's the flag. I've mentioned everything of it as much as I could. If I haven't, I'll explain it next time. That trade takes precedence over the sea and the skies and under the sea as well. So all the land under the sea is joined to the dry land. And you can see that with reclaimed land when they fill it up to take the foreshore line and make another title on it. Those titles come out of this jurisdiction of Admiralty Court-Martial Law on anyone who breaks our laws. All the laws origination come from here and native chiefs. So all your native chiefs in Canada and America, you're going to take one shot. One shot with this flag and it's all over. Stop the carnage. Stop all that, because they're using this flag. This Maoris over here are giving the consent to the Prime Minister here, who gives the consent to the Governor General, who gives the consent to the Queen, who gives the consent to the thugs to go and shoot everybody, rape them, and steal their lands and their birth certificates and natural resources for their own wealth, for the elite, the cabal, and the Illuminatis, and all those Bilderberg people in America and the US Federal State and Obama and the real estate people, Trump and all his cronies, are just about to end. But I've got something going with Scotland, with the Notary Public, who does properties in Glasgow. I'm not entirely getting rid of everybody just for the sake of getting rid of everybody. No, I'm a commercial man. I'm a contract man. And international contracts at that. I've schooled myself up in a lot of areas, but I'm an avid real estate salesperson or in the agency of selling and buying properties. Still going to carry on with that legacy for a while. That hasn't gone away, won't go away for in a hurry. But I'm more passionate about the bank, the Moai Powerhouse Bank. This flag, its authorities go around the world, 250 countries, and put these big giant turbines in the sea to split the seawater into electricity, into hydraulic power, into mechanical power to drive generators, superconducting power generators to make electricity, to split the water completely using up all electricity to make hydrogen gas, dry gas into liquid gas, into solid metal gas for rockets, and liquid hydrogen gas for jet fuel to power up vehicles and so forth, and convert back to electricity from the gas in hydrogen metal. Okay, so we've got all the technology going together. I've put it under contract to all the big companies who come under this flag and buy the contracts and the license to build their products inside this big giant bridge where planes land on and refuel anywhere in the world under this flag jurisdiction. Okay, you got that? You guys up in America and Canada and Australia. I haven't got anybody in Australia yet, but I'll leave that for the last. I've got someone in Scotland, Jackie, little Gordon, and her husband, Andy, and their two kids, Jeremy and Sarah, already my family there, talking to online all the time, Skype. And it's just I'm living there. But I'm going to Glasgow to live in Edinburgh, where all the native titles in the world are, and this flag's jurisdiction, to exercise the right to those titles that have been derived from King George IV in that period, 1820 to 1830. Those titles were put together in our time period, at least, when this flag became operational as the authority for the banknotes of King William III. The Bank of England Act and the Mines Coins Act and Pound Note Acts and the Bank of England Act. I'm using those acts to bankrupt the Rothschild banks and the Bank of England and put it out of business with one shot. David and Goliath, one shot with this flag. This flag is the flag of all flags in the world of trade, commerce and private contracts. That's nobody's business at all. Only me and the other person I'm putting on trial in the Magistrate Court in Epsom, Auckland, New Zealand. the Magistrate Court, and I'm the Magistrate there, and the Sheriff, and everything rolled up in one, because no one is able to do that job yet. I won't rely on you money with your stamp anymore, because I'm reading through the requirements for the internal affairs and the foreign affairs to England, and every other country is all different, and it says it must be a notary public lawyer of standing that can seal these documents to make them real, authentic. Once that's done, that's the law of this country and the rest of the world with this flag. That's the law of Britain, UK, dual government in a federal state sense. This is the only federal state king's flag in the world, where all the other federal states have been derived from this federal state king's flag. He created the laws, and those are the laws I'm using. I'm King William III laws, King William IV laws, King George IV laws. I'm using those acts of Westminster Parliament, where I'm going straight into, through the DUP party in Northern Ireland, my own people, my family, the Cosgroves, and the Cosgroves and the Rogans there, and the Patricks, that me, okay? I was going to